We're back now with a quick dose of Colorado Point of View. Right now, President Joe Biden's plan to eliminate $400 million of student loan debt is in the hands of the U.S. Supreme Court. That court now has a conservative majority that seems likely to reject the forgiveness plan. Here's a bit of what the justices are saying today in court, starting with one of the three liberal justices who cites the HEROES Act and the authority of the White House in a national emergency. Listen.
Congress could not have made this much more clear.
This is a grant of $400 billion, and it runs headlong into Congress's appropriations authority.
$500 billion is being diverted to one group of favored persons over others.
This decision will likely come in May or June, and with it, political consequences. Let's bring in our Colorado Point of View analyst, Democratic strategist, and senior presidential and gubernatorial advisor, Andy Boian, and Republican strategist and new director of the Advanced Colorado Institute, Michael Fields. Gentlemen, good to see you. From what you've heard today in the oral arguments, Andy, is there any chance the court decides to uphold this and the forgiveness actually goes into place?
I'm sorry, Matt, and I'm sorry to those that are supportive of this, but I don't see any light at the end of the tunnel on this at all. Based on not only just the oral arguments, but what Robert said, particularly the Chief Justice, about separation of powers. Well, he talked about the major questions authority clause inside that allows Congress to respond to these things. It really comes down to really separation of powers. What does the president have authority over and what does he does not, clearly? And I think at the end of the day, they're going to rule against this.
Michael, you agree?
Yeah, I totally agree. And you can just hear it in the oral arguments, you know, that you have kind of six of them on one side and three on the other arguing this. And it really does come down to separation of powers. If you want to pass something like this, you pass it through Congress. They have the authority to do it, not the president. You elect members of Congress to make these types of decisions. And these emergency powers don't give you, in COVID, don't give you the authority to do, you know, campaign promises and try to fulfill them through executive order.
Some people may ask, okay, so the authority during the COVID national emergency did allow them to pause the interest and pause the payments. How is this any different from that?
Well, the difference is really, it depends on when the order comes down, when the decision comes down, because right now it is on pause and people are not paying. But when this decision comes down, depending on what it is, and I think it's going to be against, these payments start again.
Right.
And so the process of this all happening has a lot of people on edge because they, you know, this could be up to $20,000 of forgiveness per loaner. But I think at the end of the day, really, it's going to be a question of authority, and it's going to come down to the fact that really the president didn't have the authority to do this.
Michael, with this, are there potential consequences for Republicans? They're the ones who are speaking out. It's Republican attorneys general who are the ones filing some of these lawsuits. And now all of a sudden people thought they were going to have some extra money or money taken away, and now they won't. Is there potential backlash on the way?
There could be, but I don't think so. I mean, you look at even the polling during this time, it was about 50-50. And I think a lot of it, and the justices even talked about it, the fairness argument of this, of people who paid off their loans, who made different decisions, went to different schools in order to try to keep their loans down. I agree with Andy that this has a lot more to do with forgiving it totally than just delaying it. And so, you know, I don't know what the political ramifications are, but separation of powers is an important thing.
I heard Neil Gorsuch talk about that earlier. Gentlemen, thank you. We'll see you this weekend. More, you can get always more analysis from Andy and Michael on Colorado Point of View. It airs Saturday nights now, just Saturday night at 7:30 on our news partners, Colorado's very own Channel 2. You can also catch the full episodes at your leisure at kdvr.com.